In our topic comparing quantities, we are dealing with some problems or examples. Last time we have seen some examples based on ratio, also some examples on percentage. Today we have to see prices related to buying and selling. Here sometimes we have to find out the value of profit percent as well as the value of loss percent. Means if profit is there, then we can find profit percent, and if loss is there, then we have to find loss percent. Last time we have seen that if selling price is greater than cost price, then definitely there is a profit. But if cost price is greater than selling price, then there is a loss. So we have seen how to find profit percent as well as loss percent. Also I have told you two more formulas, that is, if cost price and profit percent is given, then we can find selling price with the help of formula SP, or selling price is equal to CP into 100 plus profit percent divided by 100. And if cost price is given as well as loss percent is given, then to find the value of selling price, we can apply the formula SP is equal to CP into 100 minus loss percent divided by 100. So the formulas are very useful for us to find the selling price, cost price. Understand? So here we will see some examples which are based on this formula. So our first example is that Sohan bought a second hand refrigerator for rupees 2500, then spent rupees 500 on its repairs, and then he sold it for rupees 3300 rupees. So find his loss or gain percent. In this example, original cost price of the second hand refrigerator is rupees 2500, but he spent 500 rupees more for its repairs. So total cost price will be 2500 plus 500. Understand? So that is overhead expense. In overhead expense, we have to think about repairing cost, then workers as well as transport. So we will solve this example. First of all, write cost price or CP is equal to 2500 plus 500. Here 500 is overhead expense, means 500 is for he spent for repairs So total cost price is equal to rupees 3000. But after repairing, he sold his refrigerator for rupees 3300. So selling price or sales price SP is equal to rupees 3300. Here it is seen that selling price 3300 is greater than cost price 3000, and therefore there is definitely profit, and therefore we can apply the formula profit is equal to SP minus CP. Here SP is rupees 3300 minus rupees CP is 3000, and the subtraction will give us rupees 300. In this way, profit is rupees 300. Just now I have told you that if profit is there, then we have to find profit percent. So profit percent is equal to profit divided by cost price into 100%. Here profit is 300 divided by cost price is 3000 into 100. Here we can cancel unit place zero of 100 as well as 3000. Then we will get 300 upon 300. 300 upon 300, they will get cancelled. So we will get only 10. So 10% is the profit percent here in this example. I think you have got the idea of finding the profit percent. Now we have to see the second example here. It is given that Minu bought two fans for rupees 1200 each, means cost of each fan is rupees 1200. She sold one fan at a loss of 5%. This loss percent is given here, at a loss of 5%, and the other fan at a profit of 10%. The second fan she sold at a 10% profit. Find the selling price of each, means we have to find the selling price of each fan. Also find the total profit or loss. Here in this example, CP means cost per se, cost price of one fan is, or first fan is rupees 1200 or 1200, and loss percent is 5, means 5% is loss. Here we have to apply the formula, that is SP is equal to CP into 100 minus loss percent. Means if loss percent is there, then there it, the sign should be minus, and if profit percent is there, then sign must be plus here. So here CP is 1200 into 100 minus loss percent is 5, 100 minus 5 divided by 100. Now if we cancel unit plus 2 zeros of 100 as well as 1200, we will get SP is equal to 12 into 100 minus 5, that is 95, and 12 into 95 is equal to rupees 1140, which is the selling price of first fan. Selling price of first fan is equal to rupees 1140 rupees. Now the CP means cost price of second fan is rupees 1200, because both the fans have same price, cost price here, but here profit percent is 8%. And now by applying the formula, SP is equal to CP into 100 plus, last time in the formula it was minus loss percent, now here plus profit percent divided by 100. So it will be CP is 1200 into 100 plus 10 divided by 100. Here we can cancel the unit place 20 of 1200 as well as 100. We will get 12 into 100 plus 10, that will be 110, and the multiplication it will be SP is equal to rupees 1320. So in the second fan is sold for rupees 1320. Now the total cost price of two fans is equal to 2 into 1200, that is equal to rupees 2400 rupees. Now we have to find the total selling price. Total selling price of two fans is equal to, in the first fan was sold for 1140 plus second fan was sold for 1320, and the total selling price it will be rupees 2460. Here also it is seen that selling price 2460 is greater than the cost price of two fans 2400, and therefore definitely there is profit, and therefore profit is equal to SP minus CP, and that is equal to rupees 2460 minus rupees 2400. So profit is equal to rupees 60. So in this example we have got the profit rupees 60 by selling two fans. And now we have to see the second example here, that it is given that a man got 10% increase in his salary. We don't know his salary, but increase his percentage, 10% increase is there given. If his new salary is rupees 1,54,000, find his original salary. Means our, we don't know the original salary. Let X be his original salary. Okay. But before it, we have to assume that let original salary of a man be rupees 100. Here 10% increase is given. So 10% of 100 is equal to 10 divided by 100 into 100, because 100, 10% is 10 upon 100 of means multiplication, and 100 here 100 will get cancelled, we will get rupees 10 increase in salary, and therefore new salary is equal to our original salary is rupees 100 plus increment is 10, so total new salary will be rupees 110. Now here when original salary was rupees 100, then after 10% increment we get new salary as 110 rupees. But here for original salary we don't know, and let me assume it as rupees X, and for X original salary after 10% increment we will get new salary 1,54,000, which is given in the example. Now we will compare that 100 upon x, 100 upon x is equal to 110 divided by 154,000. Or we can write x upon 100 is equal to 154,000 divided by 110. And after transforming 100, we will get 154,000 into 100 divided by 110. Here we can cancel unit place 0 of 100 as well as 110. We will get 154,000 into 10, or we can write here 154 divided by 11, and after division we will get x is equal to 140,000, which is the original salary.